AM 1450, WCEV, Club Kids Radio, Pop Do. That was a celebrity headline conversation. If you missed out on Miguel Mancha, he's going to be at Joe's on Wee Street today competing. He is one of three comedians standing, and the competition is entitled The Last Local Standing. And he's right. If you're a Latino, you can be local, like automatically. If you're not, then you could just be crazy or insane, but you can't be local. So now you've met this guy, and one day you're going to see him on TV, and he's going to be doing his jokey jokes, and you're going to say, I know that guy. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Ooh, we have to say hello to Juanita. She's a new listener. She's also recruited listeners by the name of Carmen, Claudia, Lars, Yvette, Alicia, and Connie. These are all Facebook buddies. Facebook is one of the coolest stuff, which you can't have, young lady, because you're still a little young.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't do the MySpace either. Mm-hmm. But they don't they have websites and stuff for, like, nine-year-olds to hang out on?
Yeah.
Have you been on any?
Well, no.
You know, I asked you about all your favorite stuff, and I didn't ask you about the kind of music that you listen to and your favorite artists and things like that. Mm. Did you watch the Kids' Choice Awards when it was on a couple weeks ago?
No.
¿Por qué no? Just not into it?
I didn't know it was on.
Oh, well, there you go. Even On Demand failed you at that time. We also want to thank Teresa Rennie. Last Sunday, she was here live and in studio. She's the author of Snail Tales. She wrote this book, and she was in that very chair last week. So we'll thank her. If you missed out on that interview, go to wakeupdancing.com, and you'll be able to listen to that interview, which is all nice because it's all about morals. What kind of reading do you do?
Mystery.
They're like morals to those stories? Or is it like, you don't read Harry Potter stuff, do you?
I don't really read it. I watch the movies.
Well, that's even more boring. I fell asleep during the first Harry Potter movie. I fell asleep.
You can't fall asleep in a Harry Potter movie.
I did. And I never watched another one. Now, my son, you know, he's a pothead, Harry Potter head. And he likes those movies, but it just, I don't know. I just didn't get it. So what is it about Harry Potter that young people like you are so excited about?
Probably because it has to deal with magic.
So if it wasn't for magic,
it'll be nothing.
Nobody would watch it. Is he done now? Is he too old to be Harry Potter now? Isn't he like 18 now?
I don't know.
He's old enough to start getting old and playing kissy face, so now it's time to have no more Harry Potter movies.
Probably.
I feel the same way about Hannah Montana. That was a horrible movie. Did you watch it?
Yeah.
Did you agree it was horrible?
Kinda.
Why do you think it was horrible?
Probably because it's kind of more that, you know, it's I don't really know.
Because they play kissy face. You've got a Disney character played by Miley Cyrus, and nobody could ever tell that she's Hannah Montana. All she does is change her hair. How hard could it be?
I know.
But anyhow, I mean, it was a nice movie, and she got grounded, and we're going to go be punished, and we're going to go to Tennessee, and then she falls in love. You can't be in love when you're 15. You're 9 years old. That means in 6 years, you're going to be in love with some cowboy dude?
No.
No. No, 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 no. Kissy face happens like when you're really old. Real old. Like after college and after your degree. Yeah, when you're 50, like dad's age. Then you can do the kissy face thing. None of the tattoo stuff, none of the piercing stuff. Just wait. Just wait. So if you were going to recommend a movie that you saw this summer, Isabella, what would you talk about? You probably went to the movies even if you were in Connecticut.
This summer?
You didn't go to movies?
Well, I saw the Harry Potter.
I know, it was exciting. There was magic, I know.
That Blood Prince. And then I saw Up.
Up?
Up.
That was a cartoon. Wasn't that three-dimensional?
Mm-hmm.
So if you didn't have the glasses, what did it look like?
It looked all fuzzy.
Oh, I didn't go see the movie. But I did go to a 3D thing once called Honey, I Shrunk the Audience. And it was three-dimensional, and the wind blew, and there was like rats and stuff.
Me, it was 40.
Excuse me?
When you feel stuff, it's 4D.
They didn't call it a 4D movie. They called it a 3D movie. But when the wind blew, like, there was stuff under your seats that made it feel like things were happening.
Then it was 4D.
And then when one of the characters sneezed, like, sprinklers or water happen, like he sneezed right on top of you. So I guess maybe it was four-dimensional. I don't know. You know what I'm looking at now, Isabella? I am looking at a plugger for something called, or some place called Cafe Bella. Mm-hmm. You are the first club kid that has an entire place named after her. Like, this is yours. Like, you could go there and say, hey, that's me. That's pretty neat, isn't it? Tell us about having a restaurant named after you. If you go to 3311 West Fullerton, it's going to say Cafe Bella. And you're going to say, what a wonderful place to go. What you don't know is that Isabella Pena, who I like to call Izzy B, that's her. That's the Bella. So do you have like a special chair when you go there and you wave like a princess and introduce yourself to everybody?
No.
Why not?
I'm not into that stuff.
Has anybody ever told you when you've been there that, are you the Isabella? Are you Bella from Bella's Cafe?
And what sometimes.
Do you sign autographs?
No.
Why not? You are Bella. This is you. Now, I've never been there, so describe it. It's like a big place with your name all over the place?
It's a small place, and it has a lot of paintings.
Of you?
No.
Well, of what?
Well, there are some paintings of faces.
Of you?
Of other people, make-believe people.
Oh, okay, because you're real.
Yeah.
Now, Dad, what inspired you to decide to name this after your daughter? Which is pretty neat. I guess if I had a restaurant, I wouldn't have thought about naming it after my son, which I probably should now because he might be listening.
Well, Cafe Bella is pretty much Isabella.
You inspired food. There's something called a Bella Burger. Have you ever had one?
Mm-hmm.
Do you like it?
I do.
What's in it? Did you pick the ingredients?
No.
Well, you should. It's a Bella Burger. You should do a recipe yourself and just pick things and throw it in there and say, this is mine. This is Bella's secret recipe. And then people could go in there and say, we want Bella's secret. Like all that health food you were talking about earlier. Put some broccoli and spinach and chocolate and pudding all together. And that's Bella's secret recipe.
Nah.
You should.
It's called Bella Burger because she never really liked burgers until we made this burger and she loved it. So we gotta call it the Bella Burger.
So in order to make Choco Bella cake. So that's your favorite too, huh?
Yeah, that's my favorite dessert.
Is it because your name's on it or because you like chocolate cake?
I like chocolate cake.
Well, that's pretty neat. I've not been there, and I really should go there and visit. At least I should go to the place that's named after one of the club kids who works or who goes to the school that I go to. And if you want any more information on that, go to CafeBellaOnline.com and taste the difference. What's the difference between your restaurant and McDonald's?
Everything's made from scratch. Our croutons for our salads are made from scratch. Our sauces are made from scratch. Nothing is preserved. Everything's fresh. Fresh fruits, vegetables, even our burgers, we have make them there.
So does that mean it takes a little longer to get served?
No, we have a wonderful chef. His name is Cesar Casas. He's from the old Ambria restaurant in Lincoln Park.
Well, I asked because I've been to restaurants before where it takes a while to get served, back when I was not alone. And they would say, because we're doing it from scratch, it's going to take about 45 minutes, but it's from scratch.
It's from scratch. I got 3 superstars in the kitchen.
And when you grow up, is that where you're going to work too?
Yeah, she's going to take over.
No.
That's going to be your place.
Well, she's going to hire people to take it over.
Yeah.
And then you'll have your special chair and you'll wave.
No.
Why not? That's what I would do.
Because I'll be in the Bahamas in my hotel.
Oh, that's right. Because you're the queen that goes to Connecticut and the Bahamas with your tan.
And the Miami.
Show off with the travel. Anyhow, it's pretty neat that you've got your own place, and pretty neat that Dad brought you over. Mm-hmm. It was a stretch to bring her, wasn't it? She didn't want to wake up.
I had to pretty much drag her out.
But you know what, Isabella? We talked about this a while ago, even before school let out, and you said you wanted to come and hang out. You just didn't realize you were going to have to wake up in order to do it.
Kinda.
Sorry. So are you having a good time, though?
Yes.
Is there anything that you wanted to talk about that we haven't talked about yet so I don't forget?
Not really.
So I could just pick and choose what we talk about?
Yep.
Okay. Well, when we return, I'll pick and choose more stuff and stuff on Club Kids Radio.
Alex Rodriguez de los New York Yankees nos habla de los Boys and Girls Clubs.
Cuando tenía 9 años, Mi mamá tuvo que tomar dos trabajos para mantener unida a la familia. No llegaba a casa hasta las 11. Estaba a la calle, pero después de la escuela, ella nos dejaba en el Boys and Girls Club, nuestro segundo hogar.
Boys and Girls Club es el lugar ideal para los niños después de la escuela, para hacer las tareas, hacer amigos y jugar pelota.
Eddie Rodriguez sigue encargado del club de mi barrio. Él me enseñó a ser positivo, a creer en mí mismo y a hacer las mejores jugadas en la vida. Hoy sigo yendo al Boys and Girls Club para entrenar con Eddie, porque él es como un padre para mí.
En más de 3,000 Boys and Girls Clubs, hay gente dedicada como Eddie que ayudan a más niños a alcanzar el éxito.
Que si funciona, pregúntame a mí. Apoya el Boys and Girls Clubs, el lugar ideal para crecer.
Llame al 1-800-854-CLUB.
Yeah, what's up? I'm Dino.
I'm TJ.
And I'm Dominic.
And we're Three Below, and you're listening to Club Kids on the radio.
Hey, it's Lady Gaga, everybody. That's her real name, too. That's what her parents called her. They just called her Gaga because when she was a baby, that's all she said.
Gaga.
And they named her that. You believe me?
Not really.
That's because it's not true. If you wanted to say hello to Isabella, you could have 773-777-1450, 773-777-1450. We kind of forgot to give the phone number, and sometimes she likes to say hello, like she did earlier when she said hello to Miguel Mancha, the comedian guy. You're 9 years old. Tell me, what are the big life issues of a nine-year-old? What are some of the things that you think about as things that are kind of, yeah, I think something should be done about that?
Because
I think nine-year-olds have opinions, and nine-year-olds should be able to give their opinions, too.
I don't really know.
What community do you live in? What neighborhood do you live in? Don't give your address out, but tell us the community you live in.
I don't really know that either.
Humboldt Park, Portage Park, Irving Park.
Logan Square.
The square. Ooh, that's where the big monument is, right there in the middle of Kedzie. You're in that neighborhood? That's where my son came from. He was on Kedzie and the Verzi. So now, in the neighborhood that you live in, Isabella, what are some of the things that you think could be different? What are some of the good things about Logan Square? What might be some of the things that aren't so great about Logan Square? From a nine-year-old, what do you think?
Really nothing.
It's a wonderful place to live.
Yeah.
I thought so too, because there was a Pepper's right there and there was a pizza. Okay. Views and the news. This is what I'm going to do, Isabella. I am going to look through the pages of the Chicago Sun-Times or the Chicago Tribune, and I will read something, and you will tell me what your opinion is. So you can tell me good or bad. You should have an opinion, right?
Yeah.
Nobody ever really asks nine-year-olds what they think about stuff.
Not really.
Like you said, football is your favorite sport to play, maybe not watch. A couple of weeks ago, Michael Vick, who used to be with the Atlanta Falcons, was released to play football. He's now back. He's with the Philadelphia Eagles. Some people aren't liking him too much because he was a dogfighter guy. What do you think? Should he be back playing football? Does it matter? Is dogfighting cool? News on the news. Isabella. You know what dogfighting is?
I think is when they force the dog to fight with other dogs.
Yeah, that's what they do. It's like a ring. It's like a cage match, and they put dogs in there, and the dogs are beating each other up. Sometimes they survive, sometimes they don't. And what he was accused of, or convicted of, was putting together a league where all these guys are getting their dogs to fight each other for money, and then a lot of times the dogs were killed if they were not such great fighters anymore. So what's your views on the news? Dog fighting, yay or nay?
Nay.
Michael Vick, should he be back playing football, yay or nay?
I don't really know about that.
Why not?
Because I don't really know him.
Let me ask you this. You're in Logan Square, so you probably see a lot of people walking their dogs and things like that. And some of them have little poodles and they're nice and cute. And then some of them have these big, scary pit bulls that they say are friendly. Are there certain dogs that you think shouldn't be out compared to dogs that are okay to be in the house? Do you have pets?
Yeah.
What do you have?
I have a toy poodle.
Okay, so that's one of those little itty-bitty ones. Now, you're walking down the street with your toy poodle, and here comes a big giant Rottweiler with a big face. Do you think they should be on the same street?
It depends if how the trainer trains the dog. If it's gonna, you know, if it's aggressive, I wouldn't let Joanna, which is the name of my dog, be with that dog or even go near it.
What do you think about people that walk their dogs and carry these little plastic bags to clean up after them? Some people do, some people don't. It's a law. Tell us about the poop law, good or bad?
Good.
Because?
Because if you just leave the poop there, it's going to make a whole mess, and it's probably going to stink around the neighborhood if a lot of people doesn't clean up the poo if they have the dog.
Well, see, I'm glad you said that, but when I try to get you guys to not play in that yard right by the playground, and I always say that's where the dogs go, you guys still run in there anyway. You don't care. That's why. Think about that the next time. Think about it. Views on the news for Isabella. There's got to be some news that you should have an opinion on. Ooh, there are teachers that are being told to change grades for students because it makes the school look bad. That's in today's Sun Times. Views on the news. Isabella, grades, should they be changed?
No.
¿Por qué no?
Because the person, well, it depends on if you have good grades, then it should stay that way. But if you have bad grades, you should stay with that bad grade, because if they just for example, if I got an F and they decided to give me an A, it won't really make sense, because then
Let me ask you this. What if you really earned a D, but your teacher said, Isabella, if we give you an A, it's going to make the school look that much better. So even though you earned a D, we're going to give you an A. What would you say to that?
Yes.
The way she smiles, she wants that A, but you just finished saying that changing grades is not a good thing.
Probably you'll stay with the D, because then the person will probably feel guilty.
Well, and do you really learn?
No,
you learned that you got an A because the school needed you to get an A, but you really didn't learn anything. You didn't earn that A, you earned a D. What if you earned a D and they said you have to go to summer school and you're going to miss your vacation? Would you go to summer school, or would you rather just take that D?
Take that D.
Because you want to go on vacation. Well, views on the news from Isabella. She's from Logan Square. She goes to school over on the north side, and she likes what she's doing. And she's a only child, and she doesn't have a favorite cereal. That's what we've learned today. And you got to meet Miguel Mancha on the Celebrity Hotline, which I think is pretty cool. So is there anybody, and this usually happens sometimes when you come on the radio, and then you tell people that you were on the radio, and then they're mad at you because you didn't give them a shout-out, you didn't say hello, you didn't give them any respect on the air, yo. So is there anybody that you're supposed to say hello to, so just in case you don't want to forget? You know what's going to happen. It's okay, you don't have to.
I would like to say hi to my mom and my best friend named Justine.
And mom, she doesn't want fish. She wants a Bella cake.
Yes, I want the Bella cake. 2 slices to be exact.
How big is it? Oh, man. See, that's a lot. That's calories, man. Well, thanks to you. Thanks to Dad for coming in studio. That does it for another exciting edition of Club Kids Radio. Thank you to listener for putting up with us, the DJs. Is this something that you want to do again, Miss Isabella?
No.
You'd rather not do this again?
Oh.
You mean wake up or radio? I'm depressed now. She
radio.
Said no.
We're going to bring her back with her best friend.
She's treating me just like all the others did. Well, thanks for coming anyway. We'll talk to you later. Thanks, Dad.
Thank you.
So glad.